when he wrote it, this losing anxious putting on the Ritz.
Our God is an awesome God.
There is thunder in his footsteps and lightning in his fist.
Our God is an awesome God.
The Lord wasn't joking when he kicked them out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood. Return is very close, and so you better be believing. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from a heaven above with a wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from a heaven above with a wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. And when the sky was starless in the void of the night,
our God is an awesome God.
He spoke into the darkness and created the light.
Our God is an awesome God.
A judgment and wrath he poured out on Sodom, a mercy and grace he gave us at the cross. I hope that we will not forget, our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from a heaven above with a wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from a heaven above with a wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. With a wisdom, power, our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with a wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. God.
Jesus, and my life he can hold.
man that gained the whole world and lose his soul. I can call on Jesus. I know he'll answer. Born unto us a child is born, a son is given. At our other end, Jesus, the Son of God and the King of Kings. Let's see there. I'd rather have Jesus. And I don't have to have a diamond ring. I don't have to live in a fine house. And I don't have to have $1 million. I'd rather have Jesus, the Son of God, the King of Kings. When my body is in so much pain, I can call on Jesus, 'cause he answers me, Lord. Yeah. I'd rather have Jesus. I'd rather have Jesus. I'd rather have a Jesus. Yeah. The King. Yeshua Messiah, I'd rather have a Jesus, yeah. And when my body is in so much pain, I'd rather have a Jesus. Amen, I'd rather have Jesus. He is a good Lord. He has never failed us yet. We have failed him, or at least I have, but he has never failed us. You'd think by now I'd have all these memorized.
Son of God and Son of Man, Jesus, who died and rose again, and Jesus, he's the Lion
and the Lamb. He's the Lamb that was slain. He's the Lion that reigns. And my Savior and King, bold and the same. Who you see? And when the eyes that burn like fire. And who is he? All the wonder he inspires. And who is he? And that bore the guilty shame for no sin and gone astray. His name is Jesus. Jesus, and from the Father's honor and Jesus, a Son of God and Son of Man. Jesus, who died and rose again. Jesus, he's the Lion and he is Jesus. And from the Father's own hand. Jesus, a Son of God and Son of Man. Into your house, gathered in your name to worship you. You are the Son of God. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And you are worthy of all praise. And all glory and honor goes to you, the Lord. Oh, my children, I want to gather you together for a last great revival before I call you home. But I am giving everybody a chance who doesn't know me to know me. So I am putting it in the hearts of my servants to pray diligently for each and every one of you, that you stay uplifted in me and do not backslide. For this, the devil has asked to have you, and I will not allow him to have you. Remember, he asked for Peter too. And though Peter denied me 3 times, I raised him up to be a mighty man of God. And I will raise you up to be mighty men and women of God during the last days to which we are in. Remember, you know not the hour that I'm going to come, for only the Father knows. But in the Word of God, you will know the signs of the times. So stay in my Word. Because lo, upon your land there will come a figure claiming that he is me. He will make promises to deceive you, to trick you, to trap you. But he is false. My sheep know me, and know me well, and they will not fall for this wolf that will come in lamb's clothing. The prayers of my people are being brought by angels up to the throne room of heaven. And each and every soul in heaven gather around the throne and pray to God the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. And all of your prayers are heard. And God sends down angels to send the word back to you that, lo, I have never left you, I will never forsake you, and I hear you. America, I hear you. I hear the prayers that are coming from my people in America. And I do know that times are bad. But I also know that I am still the Lord of Lords. And I'm going to take care of everything in my own due time. Do not be deceived, though. Do not be deceived. For many will come and claim to be me, and they are not. But just listen to the small voice and seek me and repent. We have all done wrong, but God wants us to repent and to mean it in our hearts that when we stumble, and he will pick us back up. It doesn't mean that we as Christians won't make mistakes, because we will. But what it does mean is that we will get down on our knees before the throne of the Lord, and he will forgive us. Hey, amen. Oh, Lord Jesus. Well, YouTube is doing pretty good. We're up to 26,000 views, somewhere around that area, and probably by the end of the week we'll hit 27. We've been getting about 300 to 400 views a week for the last couple of weeks. And they changed the information now, so it's easier for me to read. They listed, you know, by countries. And we had a country that was watching, I think it was the Book of Revelations, chapter 21. Israel. Somebody in Israel had watched that. They like 1 Peter. They like 1 Peter. And we had one from Pakistan, from 1 Peter. And then they like Heather in the House. That's the one in that. And there was one from Turkey, but I can't. Oh, it was Mama from Turkey. 10,000 Angels, the Easter song. That was kind of out of place that I thought. But you got to remember that Turkey was the Eastern Roman Empire. It was Greek and it was Christian until 1453. And there are still about 2,000 Greek Orthodox Christians in Istanbul. And they receive death threats. They cannot repair their churches. I know the main church in Istanbul, where the patriarch is, the building was made 300-400 years ago. In the 1950s, they burned half of it down. The Turkish government said, nope, you can't make any repairs. Finally, it was, I think, in the late 80s or the early 90s when the president put pressure on Turkey, and Turkey finally said, okay, you can repair the fire from 40 years ago. And now, just finally, in the last 10 years, they're even allowing outside services, Christians, to be held in the great monasteries. Before, forget it. Now, Muslims, you can do whatever you want if you're a Muslim. But Christians weren't even allowed to ring church bells until just recently. So when I see Turkey pop up, it makes me happy, because Our brothers and sisters in Turkey have gone through heck. And I am afraid if things don't change, we may have that same type of feeling right here in the good old USA.